بسم الله نبدأ. We start with saying بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وعليه نتوكل وبه نستعين وهو الركن الشديد الحمد لله الواحد الفتاح فالق الإصباح أحمده حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له جعل في طاعته الفوز وخص أوقاتا رغب فيها عباده في الضراعة إليه بإلحاح وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله إمام المتقين وسيد الأولين والآخرين عبد ربه حتى أتاه اليقين اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah, the creator of humankind. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. I bear witness there is none worthy of being worshipped except Allah, the creator. I bear witness that Muhammad is the servant and the messenger of Allah. May the peace and the blessings of Allah be upon him. Today is the 20th day of Ramadan. It means here that there are only 10 days left of that month. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained that Ramadan has three phases. The first 10 days, rahmah, mercy. The second 10 days, it is maghfirah, forgiveness. And the last 10 days, عتق من النار, mean release from hellfire. That's the reward which we will get during the last 10 days of Ramadan. However, these 10 days are important. I do understand that all Ramadan days are important. And it was said that on the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the people, what would you wish, those in the Jannah? And they say, we wish that we go back to the worldly life for only one day so that we can fast that day. These are the blessings, what we call the blessings of fasting. However, the last 10 days also has something memorable, unique, important. And it is known among us that they are the last 10 days of Ramadan. So how do we understand the last 10 days of Ramadan? This is something I like to focus a little bit to help one another, to help each other understanding why these days are important. It means like there are things that we need to commemorate during these last 10 days, but why? They are unique by themselves. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken oath of these 10 nights in Surah Al-Fajr. If you go to Surah Al-Fajr, and that's the chapter number 89, and we find the second ayah says, وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. لَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ are 10 nights. It means these 10 nights are important. And more important also to help us understand these days is to go to Surah Ad-Dukhan. This is chapter number 44. And the third ayah that says, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatin mubarakah. Indeed, we sent down this Quran during a blessed night. Which blessed night? Well, you go to Surah Al-Qadr and you find Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. We revealed this Quran during Laylat Al-Qadr. They call it the night of power, the night of decree, the night of honor. But Al-Qadr is very difficult to translate it exactly. Rather, you have to take it as is, Laylat Al-Qadr, the night of Qadr. And the unique thing about Laylat Al-Qadr, that khayrun min al-fishar, that it is better than doing ibadah for 1,000 months equal to 83 years. This is how we understand this ayah. Now, what I want to say that there are events in our life that we all feel that we are proud of it and we need to commemorate it somehow. Like last week, it was Mother's Day. You see how the people started to make parties, wish mothers good health and recognize. Now, do you say, if someone said, well, you don't wait once a year to do that, you have to do it every day. Yes, we understand. But this is something that became part of a culture, universal culture. Like, look at this Independence Day. Many nations, they do unique things during the Independence Day. Similar, there are many events that we commemorated with pride. And why don't we do that too? The Quran. Isn't it true that this Quran was considered as a guide? Hudan lil muttaqin, as a guide for those who are seeking guidance, looking for guidance. This Quran is a unique book by itself because these were the words of Allah. And if Allah said, we revealed this Quran in Laylat al-Qadr, during the night of Qadr. And then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, iltamisuha fil ashr al-awakhir min Ramadan. He said, seek Laylat al-Qadr. Seek, celebrate, commemorate, make a unique things during the last 10 days. To if you want to catch up with this Laylatul Qadr, last 10 days of Ramadan. And in some narrations, odd days. Whether odd days or every day, it is important to make sure that we surround these days with something, I call it holiness, something important. And if you agree with me, then you are going to ask me, how should we do it? And what we know in our deen, when we want to pray, what do we do? Do we pray, make up prayers? No. We look at Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because he says, Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. So pray the way I prayed. Okay? So you have to go to him. And we have to go to him to understand the holiness of these nights. And let's see how Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam interpreted the last 10 days of Ramadan. What did he do with them? How he commemorated them? How he celebrated them. Okay, I'm going to take you to an authentic narration, authentic hadith that it says that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever the last 10 nights of Ramadan entered, he would do this thing. Let me get you the text, the exact words. It says, شَدَّ مِئْزَرَهُ وَأَيْقَظَ أَهْلَهُ. شَدَّ مِئْزَرَهُ means tighten his belly, his belt. An indication that I don't want to eat. I don't want to eat too much. A little bit is enough. And I want to do to dedicate my time for ibadah. That's why it is a culture in many Muslim countries. And the i'tikaf, what is the i'tikaf? People go to the masjid and stay there for the last 10 days of Ramadan. They used to do that. Of course, we cannot do it now, but it became an important act that Muslims would do during the month of Ramadan. So I'm not suggesting really that you go to the masjid and you stay there, but you have your house. And now with this epidemic virus and this, you know, we say we all are frustrated, we all are this and that, and we are scared, we are concerned, and that. But the only way to cope with this is to uplift your spirit. And I say, alhamdulillah, Ramadan is here to encourage us, connect more with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during these last 10 days, so we can release ourselves, release the pressures that we encounter by the minute, by the time, by the hour. And really, sometimes I say it's scary that our state, now the number of cases is heading toward 80,000, which is a scary number. But you know, what are we going to do? There's nothing except to be patient and have strength and faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as I said, shadda mi'zara, ayqaza ahla, he would awaken his family. It means he would encourage members of his family to participate in prayers. Now, shadda mi'zara, I'm not going to suggest to you to tighten your belt. Because, you know, we already during the day, we are tightening our belt. And it's only during the night, yeah, don't eat too much so you will have time to do prayers with fresh spirit. But I want to change Shadda Mi'zara, but I will keep the two letters, Shadda. Shadda, I want to change it to English and use the sheen as SH, sh, and the dal as letter D. So I use it as shut down. So we shut down, not like the government shut down. Yeah, it is almost like that. Shut down what? Your TV, your smartphone, all kind of social media, shut it down during that month, as the government would say, except emergency. It means limited time watching TV series or something, very limited time. And very limited time going on FaceTime, Facebook, Face, whatever this is. And do what? Use this time for ibadah. Like we know that you know, every night we do Taraweeh. Many of us, we keep up with the Taraweeh. And so what do you do with that is pray long, make the sujood longer, make the ruku' longer, instead of staying half an hour, stay 1 hour. Instead of praying 8 rak'ah, pray 20, pray 30. Make sure that you spend enough time in ibadah. You have to know something here, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, aqimu salat, atu zakat. There is, salat is do the salat, do the ibadah, but at the same time, they have to go together, and zakat. So I will dedicate Friday or Saturday, inshallah, at 4:30, I dedicate the time to talk about doing the zakat during the last 10 days of Ramadan, same as Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do. But for the ibadah, there are things that we need to focus on. Not that complicated, okay? So I don't want you really to rush into book of dua and you open the book and you read. If you want, you can do it. But simple thing, takbir. Every one of us can do it. Say Allahu Akbar. And, you know, I was a little child when people, before the Eid in particular, but during the last 10 days of Ramadan, they would start going into the street and saying, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. If you don't know all these things, say Allahu Akbar. And what else? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, akthiru, he says, increase your saying of Subhanallah. Praise be to Allah. La ilaha illallah. Alhamdulillah. Allahu Akbar. So, for now, that's what that you can practice during these last 10 days. And what do you need also to do? Educate yourself. You know, there are many articles, many books, many written materials online that would address the issue of the last 10 days of Ramadan. Go over it, read it, and the most important, keep up with the ibadah during these last 10 days of Ramadan. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would bless us all, and may Allah relieve us from the stress and the pressures of the difficulties of this time. And may Allah bless us all with good provision. And may Allah accept our work, and may Allah reward us for any knowledge that we gain during that month. Wassalamu alaikum.
Thank you, Imam. I will now be making Sheikh Umar Al Aboud the co-host, and he will guide us through some dua for now. Please bear with me while I go through that. Thank you. Sheikh Omar, we cannot hear you. Go ahead, Sheikh Omar, we can hear you now.
Okay. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. اللهم إنا نحمدك ونستعينك ونستهديك ونؤمن بك ونتوكل عليك ونثني عليك الخير كله نشكرك ولا نكفرك ونخلع ونترك من يفجرك اللهم إياك نعبد ولك نصلي ونسجد وإليك نسعى ونحفد نرجو رحمتك ونخشى عذابك إن عذابك الجد بالكفار ملحق اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله وإليك يرجع الأمر كله
آمين.
اللهم لك الحمد كالذي نقول وخيرا مما نقول
آمين.
ولك الحمد كالذي تقول لك الحمد يا ربنا حتى ترضى
آمين.
ولك الحمد إذا رضيت ولك الحمد بعد الرضا
آمين.
اللهم لك الحمد بما هديتنا ورزقتنا وخلقتنا وفرجت عنا لك الحمد بكل نعمة يا ربنا أنعمت بها علينا في قديم أو حديث
آمين.
أو خاصة أو عامة أو سر أو علانية
آمين.
لك الحمد يا ربنا بالإيمان ولك الحمد يا ربنا بالإسلام
آمين.
ولك الحمد يا ربنا بالقرآن
آمين.
ولك الحمد يا ربنا على نعمة الأهل والمال والمعافاة
آمين.
لك الحمد يا ربنا كثيرا كما تنعم كثيرا
آمين.
ولك الشكر يا ربنا كثيرا كما تزل كثيرا
آمين.
ولك الشكر على كل حال لك الحمد يا ربنا بكل المحامد
آمين.
أنت كما أثنيت بها على نفسك اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك
آمين.
ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك
آمين.
ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا
آمين.
اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا
آمين.
وقواتنا أبدا ما أبقيتنا
آمين.
اللهم اجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا
آمين.
وانصرنا على من عادانا
آمين.
ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا
آمين.
برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا همّا إلا فرجته ولا كربا إلا نفسته ولا عسيرا إلا يسرته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا مبتلا إلا عافيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا مظلوما إلا نصرته ولا ظالما إلا أخذته ولا صائما إلا تقبلت منه برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم فرج عن المسلمين ما أهمهم وما أغمهم من أمر الدنيا والآخرة فرج اللهم هم المهمومين ونفس كرب المكروبين واقض الدين عن المدينين واشف مرضى المسلمين وارحم موتاهم أجمعين نسألك يا ربنا أن تكشف الغمة عن هذه الأمة اللهم اكشف الغمة عن هذه الأمة اللهم ارفع عنا الغلا والوبا والربا والزلازل والمحن ما ظهر منها وما بطن اللهم ادفع عنا كورونا ومن اللهم اللهم ادفع عنا البرص والجنون والجذام، ونعوذ بعظمتك من سيء الأسقام. اللهم نجنا من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم لا يهزم جندك ولا يخلف وعدك. نسألك اللهم باسمك الأعظم ووجهك الأكرم أن تحفظنا بحفظك وأن تكلأنا بكلائك. اللهم احفظنا بحفظك واكلأنا برعايتك وكلائك. اللهم احرسنا بعينك التي لا تنام وركنك الذي لا يضام، واجعلنا في أمانك وضمانك وإحسانك يا رب العالمين. اللهم احرسنا بعينك التي لا تنام وركنك الذي لا يضام، واجعلنا في أمانك وضمانك وإحسانك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم إن هذا المرض جند من جنودك، تصيب به من تشاء وتصرفه عن من تشاء. اللهم فاصرفه عنا، اللهم فاصرفه عنا وعن بيوتنا وعن أهلينا وعن أزواجنا وذرارينا وعن جميع البلاد والعباد في شرقها وغربها. واحفظنا يا ربنا مما نخاف ونحذر، فأنت خير حافظا وأنت أرحم الراحمين. اللهم احفظنا مما نخاف ونحذر، فأنت خير حافظا وأنت أرحم الراحمين. تحصنا بذي العزة والجبروت والكبرياء والعظمة، اعتصمنا برب الملكوت الحي الذي لا يموت. الله أكبر من كل ما نخاف ونحذر، الله أكبر من كل ما نخاف ونحذر، الله أكبر من كل ما نخاف ونحذر. لا إله إلا الله، نستغفر الله. لا إله إلا الله، نستغفر الله. لا إله إلا الله، نستغفر الله. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من سوء الختام. اللهم أحسن عاقبتنا في الأمور كلها، وأجرنا من خزي الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة. اللهم اجعلنا ممن أسعدته فأدرك ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا. اللهم اجعلنا ممن صام وقام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا. اللهم ما قسمت في هذه الليلة المباركة من خير وعافية فاجعل لنا منه أوفر الحظ والنصيب. وما أنزلت فيها من بلاء وسوء وفتنة فاصرف عنا وعن جميع المسلمين والمسلمات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعل خير أعمالنا خواتمها، وخير أعمارنا آخرها، وخير أيامنا يوم نلقاك وأنت راض عنا يا رب العالمين. واجعل آخر كلامنا من الدنيا شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله، وتوفنا وأنت راض عنا غير غضبان، واجعلنا في موقف القيامة من الآمنين. اللهم أجرنا من سؤال منكر ونكير. اللهم أجرنا من فتنة القبر وعذاب القبر، ومن سؤال منكر ونكير. اللهم يسر حسابنا، ويمن كتابنا، وثقل موازيننا بالحسنات، اللهم ارزقنا أوسط الجنان بجوار نبيك نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ولا تخزنا يوم البعث يوم لقائك يا ديان، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك إيمانا كاملا ويقينا صادقا وتوبة نصوحا وتوبة قبل الموت وراحة عند الموت ورحمة ومغفرة وفوزا بعد الموت، ونسألك اللهم بعظمتك الجنة والنجاة من النار، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إن لك اللهم لا تجعل بيننا وبينك في رزقنا أحد سواك، واجعلنا أغنى خلقك بك وأفقر عبادك إليك، وهب لنا غنى لا يطغينا وصحة لا تلهينا، وأغننا اللهم برحمتك عمن أغنيته عنا، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. نسألك اللهم العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. اللهم فك أسر المأسورين، اللهم أحسن خلاصهم وردهم إلى أهاليهم سالمين غانمين، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. نسألك يا ربنا ألا تفرق جمعنا هذا إلا بذنب مغفور وسعي مشكور وعمل صالح متقبل مبرور. اللهم نسألك بعظمتك أن تحرم لحومنا وبشرتنا على النار. اللهم نسألك يا ربنا أن ترزقنا لذة النظر إلى وجهك الكريم، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اكتبنا عندك من الصابرين وجازنا جزاء الصابرين، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.
Thank you, Sheikh Omar. Thank you, Imam Talal. Before we end this meeting, I'd like to remind everyone that the ICB virtual fundraising campaign named Let's Keep ICB Thriving is in progress. If you have donated already to this campaign, thank you very much. Otherwise, you can go to icbwayland.org to get all the details. Thank you very much for joining us. And with that, we will call this meeting to an end. Thank you, Imam Talali. Thank you, Sheikh Omar. Good night, everyone. Thank you. Good night.